Fishin Affliction. Hello.
It's time to wet a line. It's Fishin Affliction time.
Well, Mom and Dad's grabbed the kids, it's time for the fishing show. Me and the big dog's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, and we've got it bad.
I've got that fishing affliction.
Just like me. Here, fishy, fishy here, fishy, fishy here, fishy, fishy here.
It's time to wet a line. It's Fishin Affliction time, and thank you for tuning in again today. This is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin Affliction here at the HD Studios. We'd like to continue our introduction of Fishin Affliction TV here on News Channel 5 Plus, our new home, with part two of Inside Team Fishin Affliction. Be sure to check out our exclusive online store at our new website, fishinaffliction.com. You can check out our video archives anytime on YouTube. And stay tuned for our featured Team Fishin Affliction Facebook Friend of the Week coming up at the end of the show. So sit back and relax and enjoy Inside Team Fishin Affliction Part 2 with your co-hosts, the Big Dog and the Man on Fishin Affliction TV.
Well, folks, the big dog sure catches a lot of fish here on Fishin Affliction TV, but because you catch a lot of them, you sure miss a lot of them, too.
I do remember one occasion in 1982 that I did lose a fish.
It's funny. Seems that this one that you missed down there near Nickajack was just about a year ago.
Well, you don't have to keep everything on film.
Golly Moses.
Biggest fish I've caught in a while. And I'm just letting him stay down. I'm pulling out here in the middle. I'm just letting him stay down until he burn out. Dan?
Yeah.
Normally I am pulling these up and want everybody to see them jump and you know, see how big they are, but this one here, I don't want him to jump again. That is a big fish right there. I guarantee you that fish is over 7 pounds. I guarantee you he's over 7 pounds. I guarantee that.
Fish, get away.
Should've netted that fish. Should've netted that fish. That was an absolute toad. That was a toad. I should've netted it. Oh well, I mean, he was a giant, all I can say. No doubt that fish was over 7 pounds. I mean, heck, laying on his side up under the front of the boat. Made one last jump and throw that hook from slack line.
Well, big dog, that one got away.
Well, why don't you show them the next Godzilla fish that didn't get away?
Oh man, what a giant. Look at this giant. Oh my goodness. What a giant.
Wow, what a fish.
You know what?
That's one Brother Bill Dance would be proud of right there.
That is a big old fish.
That is one Brother Bill Dance would be proud of. Come over here and give me my Strike King jig back, buddy. Come here and give me my Strike King jig back. Oh, you big boy, you.
Big dog.
Let me stand up. My heart's about to give out on me. Son, you know what? That's what I refer to as Godzilla.
Big dog, the official largest largemouth has officially been caught on Fishin Affliction.
I don't know. That fish will go 6 pounds anyway.
Well, folks, at the time, this was the biggest largemouth caught on Fishin Affliction TV, a 6.5-pound old hickory giant. Well, folks, I hope you're enjoying the opportunity to meet Team Fishin Affliction, the big dog, and myself, as much as we're enjoying the opportunity to meet you fine folks right here on our new home, News Channel 5+. And in a moment, we'll be back with some more Fishin Affliction TV. But right now, it's time to see some pictures from this week's
In the Wild.
Well, folks, the ultimate sportsman, Mr. Jim Summers, has absolutely loaded down his freezer with wintertime crappie. On a recent guide trip to Kentucky Lake, Jim enjoyed a great day of fishing, catching a whole bunch of crappie, and catching some monster crappie. And folks, I don't know what's bigger in this picture, the crappie or Jim's smile. Folks, you can send your pictures to pics@fishinaffliction.com and be sure to check out all the picture galleries there at fishinaffliction.com, and maybe you'll see your picture right here on the big screen.
In the Wild. Your pictures in the wild. Brought to you by Triton Stone. Let your imagination go.
Let your imagination go with Triton Stone of Nashville, offering the largest premium selection of natural stone and highest quality kitchen and bath products in the nation. Spectacular granite and marble countertops and flooring, unparalleled artistic and glass tiles, designer faucets and sinks for the kitchen and bath, and even care and cleaning products. Enhance your home with Triton Stone Group of Nashville, 615-613-0440.
Smyrna Ready Mix is an established company that handles business daily with integrity and professionalism. Whether you're a general contractor, professional builder, or a do-it-yourself homeowner, SRM has your concrete solutions. With several convenient locations in the Middle Tennessee area to serve you, the only call you need to make is to SRM, ready to serve you with integrity and professionalism.
For those who've got it bad. Brought to you by SRM, Smyrna Ready Mix. Serving you with professionalism and integrity.
Well, folks, here's the tournament trail results from Mike's Saturday morning tournament held on Percy Priest on November 26, 2011. In first place with 12.40 pounds, a team of Jeremy Hurd and Larry Holland. In second place with 10.95 pounds, Mr. Danny Hankins. First big fish was 5.12 pounds caught by Jeremy and Larry, and the second big fish weighed 5.06 pounds caught by Charlie King and Jim Douglas. Congratulations to all those who participated, and thanks to SRM for sponsoring the tournament trail. And now back to Fishin Affliction. Folks, welcome back to Fishin Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by Clark Marine down in Franklin, Tennessee. They offer the very best of Ranger boats, Triton boats, Sea Arcs, Express Aluminum boats, Sea Rays, and Veranda Pontoon boats. And folks, they have been serving you with excellence for over 30 years. For all your boating needs, be sure to see Stuart and the award-winning team of Clark Marine, and check out their incredible interactive website at clarkmarine.com down in Franklin, Tennessee.
Folks, here on Fishin Affliction TV, you're going to meet a lot of pro staffers that sure know their stuff on the water, big dog.
lot of them. And these guys are experts on every lake in the state.
How about the old man of the river?
He's the best.
Yeah, good, man.
What you got?
Big small, big large mouth.
You need a net?
Probably. He's pretty good fish.
Watch your thing knocking that.
Might be a small mouth.
Ooh, big smallmouth. It is a smallmouth, isn't it?
Yeah. Hold that one up.
Charles? That's a really solid smallmouth, but I don't think he'll fit in the box with the other fish.
There you go. Charles?
Guys, these are the ones that's about 145. We're turning some of these fish loose. We dag them, sure don't want to lose any of them. And here's just some of these big trophy fish. The rods have done their job. The Strike King baits have done their job today. We've had an awesome day.
And that's only half the net.
Yeah. All right, now we're going to let these go.
Okay.
And what about Kentucky Bay?
The legendary Stump Spencer.
Stomps on one too. That is a tank. What a tank, big dog.
All right, go and grab Stump.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Stump, you caught this one before.
What do you have, Stumper?
Pretty healthy. Think of that. He's healthy.
Hold that one, big dog, for a second. Get it, Stump. We are in some fish.
Woo. This is what you call Big Daddy Double.
Hey, you gotta be double. You gotta be Fishing Affliction to be
Big Daddy Double, by golly.
That's awesome. Boxer, I'm fishing.
This one here, if he's not a big one, I'll be surprised.
Like this?
I mean, maybe he ain't a big one. Maybe he's not a big one. I don't know. But he sure felt bigger than that.
I mean, he's a solid one anyway.
He ain't a big one.
What'd you got, V?
All right, I got the first one of the day.
You sure do.
Hey, don't rub it in.
Swing him over to Stump.
That's a little fella. Well, I'm trying to tell you. I hate to tell you.
He's not a keeper.
Gosh, get the net, get the net. And in the winter time, who do you vertical fish with?
The best, Mickey Bet.
That is a big old largemouth. Oh, what an absolute toad that is, Mickey. Oh my goodness, what a toad. What an absolute toad that is. That is a giant, Mickey. That is a giant. Good job, big dog. Good job. What a big old giant largemouth. That's what we come for, boy. We finally got a good one today. And you said we'd end up catching one for the other day, and we did. Maybe we'll get another one before dark. We got another 30, 45 minutes anyway.
34 degrees out here. We've caught a bunch of fish.
That's a good one there. Anyway. Let her go.
And folks, if you're wondering what can happen if you're in the boat with two Fishin Affliction pro staffers at the same time, well, how about catching the biggest fish ever caught on Fishin Affliction TV? And that's exactly what happened when the Big Dog and Stump Spencer saw Affliction pro staffer Chuck Walden catch this absolute gargantuan largemouth that weighed over 9 pounds on Kentucky Lake.
Oh, God! Golly! Here, get netting for him, Stump. Netting, Chuck, just keep. Oh, what a bass. Oh, golly, what a bass. What a bass.
This is a toad.
That fish is every bit of 9 pounds, I guarantee you. That's probably the biggest
That fish is probably the biggest bass ever caught.
What'd you catch it on?
On a six.
Strike King.
I can't.
6XD.
I'm afraid to turn loose of
him. I got him, buddy. I got him. Hold on.
That's take my picture with this.
Oh my goodness.
I told you
what?
He was a head shaker.
What a fish.
He wasn't getting off either. Made him right in the jaw.
He like jerked that rod out of your hand. I stand there looking at it. It ain't no wonder, is it? You got scales?
Yeah, I've got some.
You gotta have some scales, Rusty.
Right there under the thing. Look, right there under that thing. What an absolute monster. Right on.
I told you we couldn't catch no good ones.
Boys, well, that's the biggest fish in Tennessee waters that I've ever had. That's my biggest fish.
He's shaking.
I am shaking.
Hey, you care if I really mean what? Yeah. You do.
There's just 6XD, buddy.
That is a monster. I guarantee you that fish is every bit. I guarantee you that fish is 8'2".
Yeah, I think he's 8 pounds.
That is an absolute giant, man. Congratulations, Chuck.
You know, my son said, Dad, don't catch them all on practice day. Oh, my God.
Well, I'm telling you, that is an absolute giant. Stand up there beside him.
We'll go ahead and weigh him out.
Well, folks, now you see what happens when you have two outstanding Fish and Affliction pro staffers in the boat together. You have Chuck catching an absolute monster fish and the legendary Stump Spencer doing the honors of weighing them. And this fish was over 9 pounds, folks. And what do Fish and Affliction pro staffers do when they catch a fish this big?
That's an absolute gorgeous fish, Chuck. Here, do you want it? Here. All right, guys, here. Put him in the live where we'll save her to the end of the day and make sure she does good.
Then better turn her loose right here.
If you want to, you can turn her loose. Go and turn her loose if y'all want to go and turn her loose.
I'd rather turn her loose. I really would.
All right, well, go ahead and put her out there.
I don't care what you do, but I've been looking for a string of them.
See you, buddy.
She went right down, too. Woo, congratulations,
yeah.
Guys.
That was a toad.
Well, folks, not only does our pro staff consist of unbelievable fishermen, but they are also true sportsmen in every sense of the word. And we are proud to have them as part of Team Fishin Affliction. Folks, we'll be back in just a few moments with some more fishing action right here on Fishin Affliction TV. But right now, it's time to hear from the voice of Fishin Affliction, Mr. Matthew Gillen, as he tells us about the weekly Team Fishin Affliction special from Clark Marine.
Thank you, and here is a 2006 Triton 21XHP with a Mercury 225 Pro XS Optimax engine. Also features a Lowrance 332C color GPS and Lowrance 102C in the dash. Has a motor guide TR82, and this is a sweet deal, folks. So call now for special pricing or cruise on in and see Stewart and the award-winning team at Clark Marine Sales. Baytonsville Road, exit 61 off I-65, Franklin, Tennessee. Now let's head upstairs to the kitchen and see what Miss Vic's got cooking this week.
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Kleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter, and we have gotten so many requests from our viewers who also hunt for a great recipe for deer meat. So today, I'm gonna show you this awesome and easy recipe. You will need 2 to 3 pounds of deer meat, 1 package of onion soup mix, 1 tablespoon of soy sauce, 1 tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce, garlic powder, 1 can of cream of mushroom soup, 1/4 teaspoon of pepper, and 1 tablespoon of butter. With your deer meat already in your crock pot or slow cooker, next you're gonna add the package of onion soup mix. Next, add 1 tablespoon of soy sauce, 1 tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce, sprinkle on garlic powder, add 1 can of cream of mushroom soup, add about 1/4 teaspoon of pepper, add 1 tablespoon of butter, and 1 cup of water. After you mix all the ingredients together, let this cook on a low setting for at least 6 hours. After 6 hours, this deer meat smells delicious. Your family is gonna love it. You can find this recipe at intheskillet.com. And be sure and click on the YouTube icon to see this recipe, as well as all of my other In the Skillets. I'm Vicki Porter. Tune in next week to see what's cooking in the skillet.
I am Strike King.
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 According to the United States Coast Guard, nearly 50% of all accidents on the water are a result from alcohol use.
Whether on land or water, alcohol consumption impairs your judgment, balance, vision, and reflexes. But on the water, these effects are magnified by long hours in the sun, along with vibration, noise, and fumes coming off the boat's motor.
There is no safe threshold for recreating under the influence, and the end result can be devastating. So be responsible and think before you drink.
Hey, we're throwing information at you every week, a lot of it. But listen, you can go learn more after the show goes off the air by going to our Facebooks. Dan and Rusty have an excellent Facebook. I have a Facebook, just Doug Markham. And then you have the websites too. You got Fishin Affliction, you've got DougOutdoors.com, you got TNWildlife.org. All that will tell you a whole lot about what's going on right here in Tennessee. And you can use the methods that you see, what you learn all over the country. But if you come into this state and you want to know about rules and regulations and what to catch and where to hunt, go to those sites and we'll help you out all we can. We'll see you next week right here on Fishin Affliction.
Welcome back to Fishin Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by U.S. Reel, when performance means everything. Aris Rods, don't follow, lead. Cigar Line, always the best. Mustad Ultra Point Hooks, stays sharper longer. Onyx Life Jackets, keeping you there. Frayville, trusted gear since 1938. Blakemore's Reel Magic, the name says it all. Deca Gel Batteries, Stay in Charge Battery Charging Systems, Rugged Electronic Mounts provided by Ram Mounts, Lowrance Electronics by BBGMarine.com, and Tournament Wear. Look great, feel great, do great.
Planer board just went off and it's monsoon.
I think you got a fish out of my friend.
Well, folks, on Fishin Affliction TV, you'll see us making a ton of casts trying to catch some fish, but every once in a while, we'll do things a little different.
Like when we went trolling on Del Hala, and Luke had to catch him in the rain this time.
Okay, step down from there, and I'm going to get your planer board off when he comes up to the boat. Let me know when you get it up.
I'm going to stay here until then.
Okay, lift it up out of there and keep it up.
Oh, that's a good fish. Come on back there.
Sock him up?
Yeah. Oh, that's a big smallmouth.
You hop up there if you want. I can slow it down, but we're headed right into it. Come film from over here, you're getting ready. I'm gonna steer behind you. See it all? See what's happening? Yeah.
There you go, Luke. I can't really tell how big the fish is.
Ooh, that's a pretty good smallmouth right there.
That is a pretty good smallmouth.
You win, brother. Oh, look at that trophy. Holy cow, that's a beauty.
Smallmouth.
He's the only fish worth this, bro.
That is a good smallmouth right there.
That one got to be a keeper. That's got to be 21 inches easy.
Oh, yeah, that's a big, solid smallmouth right there.
Let me get out of the rain.
All right.
There he went.
All right. Just when you
said... Hey, Luke. Good job, boy. Good job, man.
All right. Heck yeah, man.
Fish, man.
You know, you are a trooper, man. You're out there. That heavy rain.
Folks, a lot of times I'm the third guy through. And that means the big dog and whoever the Affliction Pro Staffer is of the day that's coming there to go fishing with us, well, they've caught most of the fish. But every once in a while, I get on a roll.
And when he does, you gotta throw some water on him and cool him down.
Isn't that pretty,
Stal? It is. Good job. That's good fish, too.
Now you can stick that one in the box.
Is that a boxer, big dog?
Yeah, I put that one in the box. May as well.
That's pretty.
He smiles pretty, don't he?
Yes, he smiles pretty.
I'm talking about the fish.
I thought you were talking about the fish.
You got bait out or something, Rusty.
I've got a bait out. All I get to do is leave my bait out. Dan's gonna catch another one. I might as well keep his camera going. I'm surprised that one made it in. I thought you.
He wasn't held on by much, just a little meat. Hey, big dog, is that a good fish?
That's a good fish, man. That's a good chunk. All of them were good chunks you caught. Dan's found a little hole over here and everybody's been just letting him throw there, and he's kicking our tail.
Big Dog, we've been doing this for almost 2 years, and I've been meaning to ask you, in front of this camera, why do you get so fired up when you catch a fish?
It's just in me, man. It's just part of the Affliction. I've seen it in you.
You have, but to be able to video the Big Dog when he gets excited, well, this is the kind of moment that you'll capture.
Oh, what a beautiful fish, big dog.
Woo! Woo! It don't get no better. I'm telling you, boy, it don't get no better than that, boy. Pick up the right bait at the right time, make the right little move. Boom! I love it. I absolutely love it. And they didn't get off. I love that better.
Oh, my.
What a toad. Woo! Man, that fires me up. I can't help it.
Big Dog, our new home, News Channel 5 Plus, new viewers, our old viewers, thank you so much for joining us here on our new home. And Big Dog, what can we watch on Fishin' Affliction TV next week?
We're going to have a show from Kentucky Lake with Fishin' Affliction Pro Staffer Sam Lashley.
And folks, the incredible amount of fish that are caught is unbelievable. So tune into Fishin' Affliction next week.
And you'll see.
Oh, look at that. You gotta be kidding me.
This week's Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend is Stacy Thurman. And thanks for being our Facebook friend. For your chance to join in the fun and become an official Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend, simply like us on Facebook. And be sure to write a comment on our wall. As always, a big thank you to all of our national and local sponsors for providing us with the most advanced technology and highest quality products and services. Be sure to visit each of our partners online through the sponsor links page on our official website at fishinaffliction.com. And this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin' Affliction TV, hoping that you'll tune in next week, because there's no doubt that Dan and the Big Dog got it bad. They've got Fishin' Affliction for those who got it bad.
People don't know, but these things will talk to you. Listen.
I love Fishin' Affliction. Yes, I do.
And he's saying,
don't throw them Strike King baits around me no more.